With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Here's Cairo Santos now, ready to get this one started. And we are underway here in England. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14. About 3 yards, second down coming up.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3 yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field. I'm like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
And a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. So still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. On first down, Allen. This one into the hands of Metcalf. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it'll be second down.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short game.
And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down. To throw, it's Allen. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. Another good completion on the drive as the Vikings have a first down.
Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They've moved this football in the field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with 6 and not 3.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want their body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
They'll try to run for it with Henry. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. A good run of 6 yards there. Gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up. Henry is in. Touchdown, Minnesota.
And that caps off what was really a balanced opening drive for them, Charles. They work in the rushing game and the aerial attack, and they end it with a touchdown.
Strong in so many ways, wasn't it, partner? Their ability to throw it and run it and accomplish their goal, they've got to like the way that they started this ball game.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. They'll start this drive out on the ground and give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. A 6-yard pickup.
brings up second and four at the 34-yard line.
Fields now to throw. Flushed out right. He'll get that to Amir Smith-Marset. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Back to the air, Fields on second down. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Moore. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That one covers 29 yards. First down. Now a handoff inside. It's Peyton. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Second and 6 with the ball on the 7. Now it's Fields. Got his tight end. That's complete. It's Graham. Call it a gain of 3 on the play. And that'll lead here to a third down.
Here we go.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. Fields on third down. That's to Moore, and he's got it. Touchdown, Bears. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Bears are an extra point away from drawing level. Santos with the extra point, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time. Now, Charles, remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try to do it again.
They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Throwing is Allen on third. And that is incomplete.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a 3-and-out and giving the ball back to their offense.
That is caught, and he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 27 yards, a big play there on fourth.
Well, they picked up the first down, but I'm just going to say it. I didn't like it before the ball was snapped, and I don't like it now that they picked it up. Think about field position on their own side of the 50. They don't get it. They put their defense in a bad spot. And it's just not a decision that pays off very often.
It wasn't fourth and a yard. There was some meat on that bone.
There really was. Fortunate to get it in that situation, but not a call I would make very often.
Allen to throw once more. Short throw caught by Pitts. It'll be a gain of 5, and that's going to bring up second down. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
So from the 26-yard line, here's the 2nd and 5. On play action, Allen. And he takes a shot on the release, as this will be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Allen off the play fake. And he's got his man. It's the tight end Goddard. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 15-yard line. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. So they fake the handoff. Now Allen, a hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far. Even backed up late, they're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep him out of the end zone as the first half winds down.
Allen's throw pulled in by Gronkowski. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Now Allen again. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And inside the five here before he's out of bounds right at the three. Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up first and goal now. McCaffrey will get down close to the goal line, but not in, as he'll be marked down at the one. Give him 2 yards on that one, second and goal now. Trying to punch it in with Henry, and he'll get it in. Touchdown, Minnesota. Derrick Henry with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Vikings have taken the lead. And this one incomplete. So they went for the two. They don't get it. Should have been picked. Probably doesn't matter on a two-point conversion. But still, as a former DB, you want to grab that ball when you can, don't you?
You certainly do. And don't say it, because I know you're thinking it. Don't say it.
What am I thinking?
You know what I know what you're thinking. Well, if he'd had hands, he'd be playing on offense.
Yeah, that's true. You've said that before. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drive, so we'll see if they can shake the rust off.
Yeah, and that's always a question that you have when you have to come off the bench after having sat there for a long time. Are you ready to go? Are you loosened up? But even more so, are you mentally alert and ready to put your best product out there?
And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Here's Peyton up the middle. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Now Fields. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And now fall incomplete.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
Looking for the out route, and he's got more. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 32-yard line. Back to throw, Fields. And he'll go right back to Moore, complete again. Touchdown, Chicago! DJ Moore, as the first half is winding down. And the Bears have tied the ball game with a chance to take the lead into the locker room. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and that will give him the lead here as we get on towards halftime. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This taken in at the goal line. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with 8 seconds on the clock, really not a lot of time to try to put anything together. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback.
Here we go, Scott.
Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. This to Graham on the short pass. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
A gain of 2 brings up 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line.
Here's Fields. It's Graham again with the catch, just like the last play. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. Good work after the catch, gets him 15 and a first down.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. Here's Fields now on second down. Escaping the pressure right. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down.
Oh, partner, just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
He's got his target. That's complete. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 34-yard line. 18 yards on that one, and Chicago has the first. From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 34. They'll try the right side here with Payton. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. On first down, it's Fields. Throw right side. This is into the hands of the tight end, Tonyan. Touchdown! Robert Tonyan from 10 yards out. And the Bears take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Now the point after try for Santos. And with that, the lead is up to 8. The touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. This short throw caught by Goddard. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup. Throwing now is Allen. Oh, he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it. And they will score a